Hello everyone and welcome to Build Fix. This is my monthly series designed to help aspiring PC builders choose the parts to build with, which can be one of the hardest parts of building a gaming PC. Unfortunately, this series has become pretty challenging to do in the past couple months because pricing has gone pretty crazy. It's become very difficult to find good deals, and my honest answer to the question, Paul, what part should I build with right now, would be maybe don't build a gaming PC right now. But the flip side to that is the follow-up question, when will it be a good time to build a gaming PC? And I don't have a good answer for that either. That's part of the reason why I brought back my GPU Price Watch series so we can monitor things as they progress this year and hopefully see prices trend downward, but who knows, they might continue to go up. But mostly for anyone who's about to build a gaming PC, especially if you're doing it for the first time, I'd like you to go into this experience with eyes wide open, knowing that it's not an ideal time, but if you've taken all these things into consideration and you're still in a situation where you're like, yeah, I need a new PC right now, here is my advice. Excellent! Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise, tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumb screw for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. Before I get into what my advice is though, I'd like to say a quick thank you to PC Part Picker for sponsoring this series. PC Part Picker is a website where you can go to choose the parts for a gaming PC. They have lots of different regions listed. They have a builder where you can choose the components that will automatically check compatibility. And most importantly, they grab pricing from a variety of retailers so that you can quickly do price comparisons to see what the best deal is at the moment. Here's how Build Fix works though. It starts with a community post, which you will see if you're subscribed to my YouTube channel, so I recommend doing that if you're not already. You can then submit your build as a reply to this post. I choose two or three to go over each month. And if you want, you can also vote in the poll, which is often unrelated to the actual topic. Since it's spring, I went with flowers, and sunflower was the winner by more than 10%. Ha! Suck it, Rose. Now, because the situation is a little different the last couple months, I'm doing things a little different with my first build, which is that I'm gonna take the build I recommended last month, which was my starter recommended mid-range bang for the buck PC, and I'm gonna see if I can fix that a little bit to make it slightly more affordable, but also to see how much prices might be creeping up, because while GPUs have definitely been the biggest pain point in terms of the most expensive item to drop into a gaming PC, we're now also having to keep an eye on the prices of everything else, because everything else may or may not be having tariffs applied to it, which increases the retail price that we have to pay, often in more ways than just the base percentage amount of the tariff itself. And if you'd like a much more deep analysis of that, I highly recommend the video that Gamers Nexus posted this week, where Steve investigated the tariff situation by interviewing a bunch of people in the industry. So last month, my basic budget build had a base price of about $650. That's with a 6-core Ryzen 5 7600, a reasonable mid-range B650 motherboard, a 32GB DDR5 6000 memory kit, a 2TB NVMe SSD, a case with room for upgrades, and a 750W power supply that should be able to power most of the GPUs on the market that cost less than $1,000. About a month later, the prices for these parts have gone up ever so slightly. We're about $33 up from a month ago, which isn't terrible. The biggest price increase was definitely the motherboard, which jumped by $20, and the case, which also jumped by about $20, but that was somewhat offset by the power supply price dropping by about $15, but that is because of a mail-in rebate. Or I guess I should say a mail-in rebate and a promo code. So a little more than a month ago, I thought my go-to recommendation by this time was gonna be about that $650 base build, plus $600 more for a Radeon RX 9070 XT, which is the best bang for the buck GPU that came out in the recent launches. But that's if the 9070 XT could be purchased for its MSRP of $600, which it can't. It's going for $850, and that is just a dumb price, and nobody should pay it. You especially shouldn't pay that same $850 for the 9070 non-XT, which apparently is being marked up even more, but that is also just really dumb. The only very, very slight silver lining to this situation is that the RX 5070, which is only a 12 gig card, which is underpowered for the price range that it's currently selling for, is at least selling for only about a $60 markup over MSRP, and that basically accounts for the 10% tariff that's being applied, going from $550 plus 10%, round up a little bit to $610. The 5070 Ti, which is NVIDIA's gateway to a 16 gig VRAM buffer, which is also really silly to have to pay, is going for $900 instead of its $750 MSRP. And here, if you're comparing this to like the 9070 XT at $850, it's like choose the lesser of two evils, I suppose, between those two. But that is why, in this situation, with all these caveats, I think the $610 5070 is the quote unquote most reasonable pairing with this build. And that brings our total price to just shy of $1,300. I'm going to attempt to shave that down just a little bit more by swapping the motherboard and the storage. And no, there's just no cheaper motherboard on the market right now. So I guess we have to live with the $20 markup with the B650-S Wi-Fi going from 130 to 150. There are micro ATX options that are cheaper than that. But in my opinion, if you're going for a full-size ATX case, go for a full-size ATX motherboard to give yourself access to expansion slots and connectivity. And I'm just searching for 2 terabyte NVMe SSDs that are M.2 2280 form factor, sorting by price per gigabyte. And here again, it seems like prices are creeping up. There were 2 terabyte options in the $85 to $95 range, but beyond that Patriot P400 Lite for $105 that I had already chosen, there's maybe a couple here that are shave off $2 or $3. Here we'll go with Mushkin to save $4. And there you have it. My updated build is around $1,300. This is my heavily guarded mid-range PC recommendation right now for April 2025. The nice things here, you have an upgrade path to something like an X3D CPU for better gaming performance in the future. Lots of room in the case as well to add more storage or add on functionality like a video capture card. And in particular, if it's your first time ever building a gaming PC, I just did a tutorial on how to build this system, or pretty much this exact system. Although I did use a 9070 XT because at the time I was still more optimistic that those prices would be coming down. But yeah, I guess bump this amount up to $610 and then you'll be where I was recommending. All right, getting back to the community aspect of this video, I meant to show this at the beginning, but just as a representation of where a lot of people are at right now, Airsla1731 wanted to move to 4K, monitors are cheap enough. There's so many good monitor deals right now, but the GPUs ain't. I agree. It does feel like it's always something. Crypto mining or AI or tariffs or whatever it is, I do not blame you. I am gonna answer one comment that was very long, and I just appreciated the effort and enthusiasm that went in from Tyler Burrs here, who's building a new rig for a 13-year-old little brother. 1440p gaming and homework, of course. I'm gonna try to skim this real quick, but I chose it because it's a good example of splitting the gap between getting some new components and making use of components that you already have, or investigating the used market. I don't make a lot of videos about buying PC parts used because it's less consistent and it does introduce some potential risks. I would only wanna buy a used graphics card, for example, if I could verify it actually being plugged in and functional before I paid cash to like a Craigslist seller or something like that. But in this economy, I'm sure a lot of people are going to be at least checking out the used market, and I thought this was a good representation. All right, so Tyler got some parts for free or already has them, such as the Gigabyte X870E Aorus Pro motherboard. That's a very nice free item to have. For the CPU, we have the Ryzen 7 7800X3D for $400. This is the second best CPU for gaming. So if you can find it for a reasonable price, it actually might be worth it to go with that versus the 9800X3D. I love the CPU cooler choice of the Thermalright Phantom Spirit 120 SE. You don't need to spend $100 plus on liquid cooling, especially for an 8-core CPU. Likewise, a solid choice for the memory, 32GB DDR5-6000. The true dilemma with this build is choosing the graphics card. A RTX 4070 Ti pre-owned apparently is available for $700, or there's a 4080 Super for closer to $1,000, which is also being considered. The remaining parts are a 2 terabyte Samsung 990 Pro SSD and an EVGA 1000-watt GT series power supply. For gaming, we're looking at Warframe, Cyberpunk 2077, Minecraft with a shader pack, and we're currently gaming at 1080 144Hz with the plan to upgrade to higher refresh rate 1440 at some point soon. Look, there's even backstory. Little Bro is upgrading from an i3-12100F 6650 XT graphics card and 16 gigs of memory from about a year ago, and also not planning to sell those. That PC is going to be handed down to someone else. I love the reuse of the components and keeping the builds alive. You're so kind, Tyler. I love it. Also, like I said, this is a very long comment. His personal build just recently got upgraded from a Z790 Plus and a 13900K and a Gigabyte 4090 to a B850 motherboard, a 9950X3D CPU, upgraded the memory to 64 gigs, even swapped the power supply in the case. Wow, this is actually one of the first people I've seen who actually has an Haven HS420 that I did a video on end of last year as well. And I was about to say, wow, that's a quick upgrade going from a Z790 and 13900K, but Tyler was one of the unfortunate people who was experiencing blue screens and crashings and all sorts of instability with the 13900K. Horrific performance killing system destabilizing defects that I just lived with for a year. All right, so Tyler was kind enough to send me PC part picker links to both of the builds. He was also able to mark some of the products as purchased with $0, as well as manually inputting the dollar amount for certain things like the RTX 4080 Super Zotac Gaming Trinity, which you can absolutely not find for $1,000 right now if you're buying new. If you can find one of these used for $1,000, it is a good deal given the market right now. However, I agree with you that it's a difficult choice considering the $300 price increase versus a 4070 Ti if you do have one of those available for $700. If this was a 4070 Ti Super that also had 16 gigs of VRAM, I would say opt for that for the lower price. But I don't know, it's probably my frustration with like the 5070, for example, that makes me really hesitant to recommend purchasing a 12 gig used graphics card for $700. So between the two of those, I think I would lean towards the 4080 Super, again, because it's a seemingly good deal to be able to buy one of those for MSRP right now. And rounding things out, since you were asking for case recommendations, like cases I feel like are one of the most personal choices for a build. It has a lot to do with aesthetics and how your build is gonna look. So when I recommend, hey, this case is good or this case is good, someone might look at that case and be like, that's hideous, I don't want it. So feel free to go with something else. One of the cases I feel like has gotten a ton of positive feedback in terms of both looks and performance is Fractal Designs North. And it is still somewhat reasonably priced, coming in at $140. It has that nice wood panel on the front. If you're trying to shave a few bucks off of the price of the build to make room for that $1,000 4080 Super, the Anlee's LandCool 207 has excellent airflow, comes with a couple RGB fans. It has a pretty standard ATX layout, but again, plenty of airflow, so that's another one I'd take a look at. And then in terms of dual chamber cases, I still like Lee Anlee's original 011, and they've come out with a bunch of different variants of that. So if your hardware will fit, the 011 Vision Compact is around $125, or the 011 Vision Standard ATX is about $150, and I've done a build in this case as well. Actually, we built Joe's system in this case, and it turned out very nice, although the airflow is a little bit different since you do have three solid glass side panels to deal with. But that is going to wrap it up for this video, you guys. If you're in the market for a new PC, good luck, and I hope this video has helped you out at least a little bit. Be sure to check out my recent build tutorial as well as my ongoing GPU price guide if you want to keep an eye on pricing and see if things get better. Hopefully they do. But a big thank you to PC Part Picker for sponsoring Build Fix. You can find links to PC Part Picker, the builds, and individual components in the description down below, as well as a link to my store at paulshardware.net where you can buy shirts, mugs, pint glasses to help support my channel and get yourself some awesome merch. Thank you once again. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you're not already. We'll see you all in the next one.